Good afternoon and welcome to all. So in the last session we have discussed about the different steps in the Krebs cycle. Here the two carbon atoms are oxidized to carbon dioxide, and the energy from these reactions are transferred to other metabolic process through ATP or GTP. And as the electrons in the NADH, and this electrons in the NADH can pass through the electron transport chain, that is QH2. The NADH generated in the citric acid cycle may later be oxidized to drive the ATP synthesis. So it can be either oxidized or donate its electron to drive the ATP synthesis in a type of process known as oxidative phosphorylation or electron transport chain. The next molecule intermediate is FADH2. This FADH2, it is covalently attached to succinate dehydrogenase, an enzyme which functions both in the CAC and in the mitochondrial electron transport chain in oxidative phosphorylation. The GTP that is formed by GDP forming succinyl CoA synthetase, it may be utilized by nucleoside diphosphate kinase to form ATP. So this GTP can be formed, which is utilized to form ATP. The catalyzed reaction is GTP plus ADP, which gives GDP plus ATP. So this FADH2, the intermediate, it facilitates the transfer of electrons to coenzyme Q. This coenzyme Q is what? It is nothing but the final electron acceptor of the reaction catalyzed by succinate ubiquinone oxidoreductase complex, and they act as an intermediate in the electron transport chain. So this FADH2 enters the electron transport chain. Next is the describing about the products. Again, the products of the first turn of the cycle. So in the one turn of cycle, the products we get are 1 GTP or ATP, 3 NADH and 1 QH2 and 2 CO2, that is carbon dioxide. Because of the 2 acetyl CoA molecules are produced from each glucose molecules, 2 cycles are required per glucose molecule. So from the glucose molecule, 2 acetyl CoA molecules are produced. So 2 Krebs cycles are required for 1 glucose molecule. Therefore, at the end of the 2 cycles, the products are 2 GTP, 6 NADH and 2 QH2 and 4 carbon dioxide. These are the description of the obtaining what the sum of the reactions in the citric acid cycle. So the reactants are acetyl CoA plus 3 NAD plus UQ and GDP plus PI plus 2 H2O, which gives CoASH plus 2 NADH plus UQH2, then 3H plus plus GTP plus 2 carbon dioxide. Combining the reactions occurring during the pyruvate oxidation with those occurring during the citric acid cycle, the following overall pyruvate oxidation reduction is obtained. The pyruvate ion plus 4 NAD plus plus UQ plus GDP, which gives 4 NADH plus UQH2, 4H plus, then GTP plus 3 carbon dioxide. Combining the above reactions with ones occurring in the course of glycolysis, the following overall glucose oxidation reaction is obtained. So the glucose plus 10 NAD plus plus UQ plus 2 ADP plus 2 GDP, this all gives 10 NADH, then 2 UQH2 plus 10H plus plus 2 ATP plus 2 GTP plus 6 carbon dioxide. So this are the overall reaction. This above reactions are balanced if the Pi inorganic phosphate represents H2PO4 minus ion ADP and GDP, the ATP2 and GDP2 ion respectively. So this ATP and GTP, the ATP3 and GTP3 ions respectively. So nothing but the total yield of ATP molecules which are obtained after the complete oxidation of 1 glucose in glycolysis, citric acid cycle and oxidative phosphorylation, it is estimated to be in between 30 and 38. Next is the efficiency of the Krebs cycle. The theoretical maximum yield of ATP through oxidation of 1 molecule of glucose in glycolysis, citric acid cycle and oxidative phosphorylation is 38, assuming 3 molar equivalents of ATP per equivalent NADH plus 2 ATP per UQH2. That is nothing but FADH2, UQH2, okay. Next is the regulation of the TCA cycle. So, first mode of regulation is allosteric regulation by the metabolites. Here, the citric acid regulation, it is largely determined by the inhibition of the product and substrate availability. So, in allosteric regulation, here deals with the inhibition of the product and substrate availability. If the cycle were permitted to run unchecked without any control, large amount of metabolic energy are released and this could be wasted in the overproduction of reduced coenzymes such as NADH and ATP. The major eventual substrate of the cycle is ADP, which gets converted to ATP. A reduced amount of ADP causes what? Accumulation of precursor NADH, which in turn can inhibit a number of enzymes. NADH. It is the product of all dehydrogenases in the citric acid cycle with the exception of succinate dehydrogenase. So, NADH is not present within the succinate dehydrogenase and this NADH inhibit pyruvate dehydrogenase, isocitrate dehydrogenase, alpha KG and that is alpha ketoglutarate and also citrate synthase. Acetyl-CoA inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase. Next molecule inhibiting this enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase is acetyl-CoA, while succinate-CoA inhibits alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase and citrate synthase. Next important regulatory mode is citrate. It is used for feedback inhibition because it inhibits the enzyme phosphofructokinase, an enzyme which are involved in glycolysis that catalyzes the formation of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, a precursor of pyruvate. This prevents a constant high rate of flux when there is an accumulation of citrate and a decrease in the substrate concentration. Next is regulation by calcium. The calcium is also used as a regulator in the citric acid cycle because the calcium levels in the mitochondrial matrix, that is in the case of the eukaryotes, it can reach up to tens of the micromolar level during cellular activation. It activates the pyruvate dehydrogenase phosphatase. So, this calcium activates the enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase phosphatase, which activates the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. And this calcium also activates isocitrate dehydrogenase and alpha KG dehydrogenase, alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. This increases the reaction rate of So what happens in this condition? The calcium activates the enzyme isocitrate dehydrogenase and alpha KG, that is ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. This increases the reaction rate of many of the steps in the cycle, therefore increase in the flux throughout the pathway. So calcium, so that's why the calcium is regulated. Next is regulation in the transcription, that is transcriptional regulation. Recent work has demonstrated that there is an important link between the intermediates of citric acid cycle and regulation of hypoxia inducible factors. This hypoxia inducible factors play an important role in regulation of oxygen homeostasis and also in the transcription factor that targets angiogenesis, vascular remodeling, glucose utilization and iron transport and apoptosis. This hypoxia inducible factor is synthesized constitutively at least what happens is that it plays a role in the oxygen homeostasis and also a transcription factor that targets in the angiogenesis, vascular remodeling, glucose utilization, iron transport. And then this HIF is synthesized constitutively. That means constitutively means in the constant mode, and hydroxylation of at least one of the two critical pollen residues mediates their interaction with the von Hippel Lindau. And this von Hippel Lindau E3 ubiquitin ligase complex, which targets them for rapid regeneration. So this reaction is catalyzed by the prolyl 4 hydroxylases. Fumarate and succinate have been identified as potent inhibitors of prolyl hydroxylases. This indicates. So this lead to the stabilization of HIF. Next is the other molecules other than carbon dioxide, carbohydrate, sorry. Some bacteria have an enzyme called tryptophanase, which can form pyruvate from amino acids. So they are capable of forming amino acid, that is tryptophan. Pyruvate can then be metabolized in the Krebs cycle. Other bacteria can break down this amino acid cysteine instead of glucose, cysteine into substance that enters the Krebs cycle. They also may enter the Krebs cycle other than glucose. In order for amino acids to be used in the Krebs cycle, they must be first deaminated, that is amino group should be converted to ammonia, or rather to an ammonium ion, either to ammonia or to the ammonium ion it can be converted, which can be then separated. So what happens in this condition, that is, first of all, they must be deaminated to the amino group and it must be converted to ammonia. Then in addition, there are bacteria that can metabolize. In addition to these points, there are certain bacteria which is capable of metabolizing lipids to glycerol and fatty acids apart from the amino acids. Glycerol can be converted to pyruvate and further metabolized in the Krebs cycle, and fatty acids can enter the Krebs cycle directly. Thus, there are many pathways into the Krebs cycle. So what happens, this glycerol also can be converted to pyruvate, and this can also metabolized in the Krebs cycle, and fatty acids can enter the Krebs cycle directly. Glycerol also enters the Krebs cycle by converting it to pyruvate. Not only the glucose, glycerol and fatty acids also enter the Krebs cycle directly. Thus, there are many pathways into the Krebs cycle, and bacteria with aerobic, facultative anaerobic or microaerophilic metabolism can. Therefore, extract